You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to BorisFX.com for the premium download. When you open up the standalone version of Silhouette, you're greeted by this little welcome screen, and we get a chance to start a new project, open up an old project, or look at a list of recent projects that we've been working on. I'm going to hit New Project, and I'm going to give this a name. And I'll also tell it where to save the project. And I'm going to create a new folder called Silhouette Projects, and save it in there. Now, it's important that we save our project somewhere where we can easily find it, but it's also useful to save this onto a fast drive as well. That project folder doesn't just contain a single little file. It also is going to contain other things like paint strokes and other goodies that we might need later. So it's important we have access to a fast drive for that. And here we are in Silhouette. Now, your workspace might not look like mine. If we go up to the top menu and go to Workspace, we have a number of different presets we can use, plus the ability to save and delete workspaces, which we'll come to later. And before I give you the quick tour of what we're looking at, let's actually import some footage. So let's go down to the bottom left-hand corner and go to our sources. So the sources is where we're going to be importing all of our media. And I can just double-click in the sources, and that will open up my import media window. Just cancel out of that. I can also go to File, Import, Media up at the top, and that'll bring up the same window here. And I can navigate to where my media is. I happen to be in the folder that I'm after, and because I have Detect Sequences turned on, it's collapsed all of the frames that we're going to be working on into one handy file. So I can double click on that, or click and hit Open. Now we have a project open. We have our footage imported, so that means we're ready to start working. If you're coming into Silhouette through the plugin, things are a little bit different, but actually also the same. If I add the Silhouette plugin in our host, we're going to have a few options up here, but all I'm going to do is hit Open. This is going to open up a new project window directly for us, with the same options of naming our project and choosing where it goes. The only difference is here, we also get a chance to choose what type of project we're going to be working on, whether it's paint, roto, or composite. It's not the end of the world if we choose something that we don't want. It just sets up a little template for us. And we can choose the working depth as well. I happily work at float 16 and composite, and then we go create project. And our window will look the same as it was in the standalone version. There are a couple of differences between standalone Silhouette and the plugin version, the main one being that the plugin version does not come with the Sapphire filters. This is the only one that's going to affect us during this course, and you can check out the BorisFX website to compare the two versions to see what the current differences are. In the next exercise, we're going to start our project and learn more about the user interface and how Silhouette works with nodes. So join me on the other side of the break.